A group of true blue American patriots, bikers for Trump, got together and cruised over to the Red Hen in support of Sarah Huckabee Sanders. Virginia chapter and other groups joined forces with Corey Allen Stewart, Virginia Republican, who is running for state Senate. Corey is a Republican and supports the Trump administration's policies. Corey is atop the ticket, and the establishment swamp are running scared in Virginia. Stewart is running against Tim Kaine, Virginia Democrat. Kaine is former VP running mate of failed presidential nominee Hillary Rodham Clinton. The crew of bikers met in the morning, then cruised to the Red Hen, where they peacefully demonstrated. A biker for Trump, McCall W. Ashton III, reports to usfortrump.com, "There was one deranged heckler because someone didn't want us to ride through town. We did anyway. Can you imagine the bravery or something it took for the heckler to try and stop this crew from riding through town?" They are Trump-supporting patriots all the way. As the large crowd gathered, you can see they carried the American flag to demonstrate their love for America in front of the Red Hen restaurant. There was also a huge sign, "Make America Great Again" banner. There were some homemade signs that said, "Democrats, no break for the hate," and a rather spicy punny one that reads, "Hey Red Hen, go cluck yourself."
That owner has also now just resigned from a local business organization there. Meanwhile, many in the small Northern Virginia community fear their business may now suffer. Correspondent Doug McKelway is in Lexington again tonight.
Stonewall Jackson and Robert E. Lee are both buried in Lexington, Virginia. Reminders that some civil wars are not as soft as the one Lexington is experiencing today. Numerous shop owners refuse to talk to us about the Red Hen controversy, wary that if you take a side, you risk alienating half your customers.
It's very painful for me what's happening in this country. The meanness, and I'm sorry, I'm liberal, but I'm not happy with those that are mouthing off on either side.
I hope you're not only just talking to the people that supported this woman. What she did is really embarrassment to all of us.
The Red Hen's owner, Stephanie Wilkinson, was also, until today, the executive chair of an influential business group here, Main Street Lexington. She resigned from that post this afternoon, according to published reports.
After Sarah and her husband left and the family relocated to a restaurant across the street, the owner of the Red Hen then organized an effort to go and scream at them from the sidewalk at the other restaurant.
Huckabee's story confirmed by the man who hosted the Sanders family at his bed and breakfast.
It was just an unfortunate situation, because I guess, again, if you're trying to make a statement, make the statement. Don't keep screaming it, and follow people or what have you.
200 miles to the north, a congressman who was nearly killed by a gunman with extremist views knows how far such incivility can go.
I know firsthand, we've got to be real careful about how we discuss our differences. The great part of America is that we can discuss our differences freely and openly, but we also have a responsibility to make sure that we're not trying to incite others to violence.
More Democrats are joining Senate Minority Leader Schumer's call for civility. A spokesman for Virginia Democratic Senator Tim Kaine told the Richmond Times-Dispatch that he, quote, believes in civility and respect from everyone are important to a functioning democracy.
It was a peaceful demonstration, and the Virginia Senate hopeful Corey Stewart spoke at the protest as well. Corey Allen Stewart was heard saying, "All right, hey, look at this crew today. Who's ready to support President Trump? And who is ready to support Sarah Huckabee Sanders?" Moreover, the Senate hopefully said that pro-Trump group had the support of the state police. Additionally, Corey also stated that we're going to bring back Harley-Davidson to the states. President Trump tweeted the Red Hen restaurant should focus more on cleaning its filthy canopies, doors, and windows, badly needs a paint job, rather than refusing to serve a fine person like Sarah Huckabee Sanders and family. I always had a rule, if a restaurant is dirty on the outside, it is probably always dirty on the inside. As you'll remember, the co-owner of the Red Hen restaurant, Stephanie Wilkinson, kicked out Press Secretary Sanders and subsequently saw her 5-star rating drop to 2. Then she resigned from the local board as director of Main Street Lexington, which focuses on improving the city's downtown area. The Red Hen is now closed until after the 4th of July. Let's give a big shout out and thank you to our Bikers for Trump. Give them some love and let them know we appreciate their efforts to continue to keep America great again. Career politicians have plagued our government for longer than anyone can remember. While there are some good apples in the bunch, many self-serving swamp creatures try their hardest to stick around Congress in order to build personal wealth and maintain power. Unfortunately, the end result is stagnation and underachievement for what should be a productive but highly paid group of public servants. Now President Donald Trump is taking aim at the career politicians in Washington, D.C. The president's tweet comes just a week after he met with freshman lawmakers to talk about term limits and how they could be introduced into legislation. The president stated in his tweet, "I recently had a terrific meeting with a bipartisan group of freshman lawmakers who feel very strongly and in favor of congressional term limits. I gave them my full support and endorsement for their efforts." The idea of imposing term limits is not new to President Trump. During his presidential campaign, he stated that if I'm elected, I will push a constitutional amendment to impose limits on members of Congress. Following the meeting with President Trump, Fitzpatrick said he's hopeful that new legislation imposing term limits on federal lawmakers should and could gain momentum in Congress. Fitzpatrick said that the president was receptive to the idea of introducing legislation for term limits. Fitzpatrick also stated that he told President Trump that it was during his time working for the FBI that he saw a direct relationship between an official's time in office and their propensity for corruption. When Fitzpatrick was asked if a large incoming wave of freshman congressman members could be advantageous, he replied with optimism, "I sure hope so. It's always hard to get members of Congress to vote against their own self-interests. Now, with the support of President Donald Trump, I think the term limits can be introduced through the hard work of people like Fitzpatrick who realize that 12 years is plenty of time for a federal lawmaker to stick around." Thank you for watching Screen Hoopla News.